Thank you. Gathered here in this beautiful setting to witness a beautiful thing, the joining of a man and a woman as husband and wife. Brian and Aslan have invited us here. It's a privilege for us to be able to be here, to be a part of their wedding. And they've invited you here to celebrate because they care about you and they wanted you to be here for this special time in their lives. Brian and Aslan have known each other for a number of years, starting and dating in high school. They've been planning this marriage very seriously for the last several months or so. This wedding ceremony represents the most important commitments that the two of you will make to any person here in this world. The wedding ceremony is one of the most sacred ceremonies that's ever been created. And this ceremony is deeply significant, I know, to each of you. Brian and Aslan, I would encourage you to remember that the feelings that you have for each other are not a sufficient foundation for a happy home. I would urge you to make Jesus Christ the head of your home, the ruler of your destinies, and the object of your deepest affection. These are solemn and sacred vows that you're making to each other this afternoon. You're making these vows to each other, and you're also making vows to the Lord, and He'll hold you accountable for keeping the promises that you're making today. Each one of you is supremely valuable to God, each worth the price of the blood of His own Son. And so in your relationship with each other, I would encourage you not to devalue or belittle each other, but rather I charge you to remember how valuable your spouse is to God and to esteem and honor each other, even as God esteems and honors each of you. I urge you to pray for each other daily and share spiritual life together, joint heirs in the grace of life. I'd like to ask the parents to stand. Paul's already standing, but if Lori, Mark, and Kathy could stand. I'd like to address you just for a moment. I'd like to tell you how proud I know that all four of you are of these two young people and of their lives, where they've come to this point, and the commitments that they're now ready to make. You've done a fine job in raising these two young people. And what I would remind you of today is that your job's not done. You're done raising them, so your job's changing, but you still have several important things to do. You're to set a good example for Brian and Aslan. for what it means to have a good, strong, solid marriage. And you're to encourage both of them, not just to take the side of your child, but to encourage both of them in their marriage to each other. I would charge you to promise not to interfere in their lives, to let them be adults, to cease forever treating them as children, to be their friends as well as their parents, to love, and to reserve an extra special measure of love for the children that will be born to them in the years ahead. Your grandchildren will be your reward for putting up with them these last 20 plus years. If the four of you are willing to accept these challenges and make these promises, please answer in unison by saying, "We do." Thank you. You may be seated. Brian, do you come today ready to make a lifetime commitment to Aslan as her husband, to receive her as your wife? Do you commit yourself to make a home where she will be loved and cared for as long as God grants her life? If so, will you answer by saying, "I do." And Aslan, do you come here ready today to make a lifetime commitment to Brian as his wife, to receive him as your husband? Do you commit yourself to make a home where he will be loved and cared for as long as God grants him life? If so, will you answer by saying, "I do." Who's giving this woman to be married to this man? Thank you. Marriage can be traced all the way back to the Garden of Eden. Marriage was God's design for mankind from the very beginning of his creation. God brought Adam and Eve together in the first marriage, and he specially created Eve to be a partner for Adam. God took Adam's rib and used it to create Eve for him. God didn't make Eve from Adam's head. The woman was not designed to rule over man. God didn't make Eve from Adam's feet. Woman is not designed to be trampled on by man. God made Eve from a spot underneath Adam's arm because woman is to be protected by man. God made Eve from a spot near Adam's heart because woman is to be loved by man. God made Eve from Adam's side because woman is to be man's partner in life. Man and woman were designed with each other in mind, each complementing the other so that together they'd be stronger and better than the two of them would be when separated. The relationship of a man and a woman in marriage is a gift from God. It was provided by God to bring comfort to the sorrows of life, to magnify life's joys, to strengthen our capabilities, and to minimize our weaknesses. Marriage is two sets of hands joined together to work, two hearts blended together to love, two lives united together to form a family. Brian and Aslan, you're entering into your marriage today not solely by the authority of the state of Oregon. The seal on your wedding certificate does not make your marriage strong nor valid. Rather, you are entering into marriage today by the authority and with the blessing of God, and it will be the strength of your love and the power of your faith, both in each other and in God, that will make your marriage strong. You can have the kind of home that God wants you to have and that you want to have if you will continue to recognize God as the source of love and romance and affection, for these are his gifts. I know you've already begun, and I would challenge and encourage you to continue to build your relationship and now to build your home on a spiritual foundation. With God, you'll have everything, and without him, you'll have nothing. Solomon was the wisest man on earth in his day, perhaps the wisest man who ever lived. And certainly his wisdom was a gift given to him by God. But it also came through a number of interesting life experiences that Solomon had. He wrote the book of Ecclesiastes to talk about those experiences. There's one passage in Ecclesiastes that I especially want to focus on, in which he talks about what he discovered about life. He says, "Two are better than one, because they have a good return for their work. If one falls, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone?" That idea is the idea that's expressed in any marriage, that it will be best to be together rather than to face life alone. And I know that's part of the thought that brings the two of you here to this point in your lives. Brian, by this wedding ceremony, you are declaring that Aslan is the one that you've chosen to share your life with, to love, to have fun with, to be committed to, your life companion. And Aslan, you were declaring the same thing about Brian, that he's the one you've chosen to share your life with, to love, to have fun with, to be committed to, your life companion. But Solomon goes on in Ecclesiastes to express an additional idea that I also know is a part of what the two of you are emphasizing in this wedding. He says, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves, and a cord of three strands is not quickly broken. Jesus Christ is the third strand in your marriage, and you're declaring before this company today, before your family, before your friends, to each other, and before God, that the presence of Jesus Christ in your individual lives and your vow to make Jesus Christ a part of your marriage too. He's the glue that will make your marriage last, and not just make your marriage last, but make your marriage good. Good for each of you, good for the society in which you live, good for the people around you. The Apostle Paul talks about the kind of relationship that God desires the two of you to have as husband and wife. Paul said, be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, be subject to your husbands as to the Lord. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. Husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. Each one of you must also love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Aslan, God is asking you to respect Brian's leadership in your marriage. And Brian, God is asking you to love Aslan more than you love yourself and to sacrifice for her in whatever way you are called upon to do so. It is true that storms will hit your home, sometimes with fierce brutality. But if you commit yourselves to the Lord and to each other, he will make your home a refuge from those storms. It'll be a haven when you are weary. It'll be a place of healing when you are sick. It'll be a place of comfort and peace. And that's what God wants to be. And that's what you want it to be too. Aslan, will you pass your bouquet on to your matron of honor? Then will you, the two of you, say your vows to each other? Brian, I'd ask you first to repeat after me and say, I, Brian Joseph Notes, take you, Aslan Beth Ritz, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we are separated by death. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. Aslan, I'd ask you to repeat those same vows to Brian, saying after me, I, Aslan Beth Ritz, take you, Brian Joseph Notes, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we are separated by death. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. The Bible describes love, the kind of love that's necessary for marriage to work, in this way. It says, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. For that kind of love is your goal. You've chosen to seal your vows by the giving and the receiving of rings. The wedding rings that you'll be exchanging are very small in size, when they're compared to their significance. They're made of precious metal in order to remind us that love is not cheap nor common. Indeed, love may cost us dearly. They're made in a circle to remind us that love must never come to an end. We must keep it continuous. In giving each other these rings, Brian and Aslan, you are pledging yourselves to a lifetime together. You're pledging that no matter what difficulties you face in life, you will face them together for the rest of your life.
They're made to be worn at all times, so that whether you are together or apart for a while, they will be a constant reminder to you of the commitments that you're making to each other today.
Brian, would you take Aslan's ring and place it on her finger and repeat after me this promise? I give you this ring as a symbol of my vows. It is a reminder of our constant faith and abiding love. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. With this ring, I pledge my life to loving you. Aslan, will you place the ring on Brian's finger and repeat the same vows after me, saying, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vows. It is a reminder of our constant faith and abiding love. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. With this ring, I pledge my life to loving you. Brian and Aslan, you've chosen to include an additional symbol in your wedding ceremony today, the partaking of the Lord's Supper, which represents for us the supreme sacrifice that Jesus Christ made on the cross for each of you individually. And I believe that by partaking of communion together during your wedding ceremony, you are declaring that Jesus Christ is going to be the center of your home and the object of your affection and love and deep commitment. And the elements that have been provided today are two different types of wine that will be poured together to symbolize the joining of your two lives and your two walks with the Lord together to form this new relationship in marriage. So you'd step forward. Brought us to this place, this day, in which they're making these extremely significant vows, commitments, promises, and pledges to each other. But I pray that you bless them in every way. God, I pray that every passing year their love for each other would grow stronger. God, I pray that you help them to help each other. God, help Brian. To help Aslan in every way, to help her in spiritual life, to help her emotionally, to help her physically. God, I pray you help Aslan to be that kind of help and support for Brian in every aspect of his life. God, we know there are powerful forces at work in our world to damage and destroy relationships. So we ask, Father, that you would protect Brian and Aslan. God, I pray that every year their marriage would be stronger, be better, their love for each other. God, I pray that whatever they face in the future, that the good things they face together and enjoy, and the difficult things they face those together too, and weather them together. God, I pray that you grant to them the blessing of long life together. I pray that you grant to them the blessing of prosperity, grant them the blessing of spiritual growth. God, we pray that you can grant them every good desire that they have, every blessing that you want them to have. And we pray these things for Brian and Aslan because we care deeply for them. We pray in Jesus' name. Brian and Aslan, you've come here this afternoon in front of this group of people, all of whom care very deeply for you. And you've demonstrated your love for each other by the vows that you've spoken and by the looks that you've given to each other. You've demonstrated your willingness to make commitment to each other by the promises that you've made, by the rings that you've exchanged, by the communion that you've partaken of. And so now it gives me great pleasure, with blessing and by the authority of God Himself, to be able to pronounce you to be husband and wife. Brian, you may kiss your wife. I would like to present to you for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Brian Doe.
Yes.
And I've got your chair.
Thank you very much. I have a bag over there too.
Oh, no, I'm just kidding.
Thank you. This came from Virginia.
Stay here.
Best man.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming to Aslan and Brian's celebration of marriage. I just want to say that it's an honor. I'm so happy that I got the privilege of being their best man today. I met Brian about 4 years ago, almost exactly, probably. And our first meeting was on the telephone because we were actually roommates for the first term of college, and the first time I ever talked to him was on the phone. And my first impression of him was, you know, I didn't really think he was a real social guy on the telephone so much. It was kind of hard pulling stuff out of him. I was trying to get to know who I'd be living with for the next, you know, at least part of a year, and he didn't really have much to say. So I had my reservations of who he was and how he'd go, but he turned out to be a great guy and a great first roommate, and we actually ended up rooming together and living together a few times after that. So I was really privileged to have that kind of thing happen for him to be my first roommate and everything. And of course Andrew over there, he's cool too. But, and then I got the privilege of meeting Aslan. She's a great girl. She'd bring over, you know, cookies and pie, and really showed us that she'd be a great wife and take care of Brian, you know, because his favorite meal is peanut butter and jelly, so he'll be all right. And so I'd just like to raise my glass to Brian and Aslan and just wish them the best rest of their life together. To Brian and Aslan.
Okay, so the reason my brother doesn't talk very much is because I do all the talking. That's the issue. So I'll try and keep it short, but let's see. This relationship started a long time ago at a thing at St. Anne Christian called Donkey Basketball. And Aslan was on my little team, and I thought, this girl is made for my brother. And lo and behold, after he chased her down for so many years, he finally got her, so. I really like Aslan a lot, and I'm glad she gets to be my sister-in-law. And it's been a wonderful day having you all here at my aunt and uncle's place. And I just hope this is just the beginning of a long life of marriage together. And I love you both. So here's to Aslan and Brian. Here.
All right, well, let's bow our heads and pray, and then we'll ask the head table to go up and fill their plates. Father God, we're here today celebrating this union, and we'd ask your blessings on food, fellowship, God, that this day would glorify you. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. So lead us off, folks, to getting some great food, and maybe we could go in order of table numbers. If that might be easier.
The children's carousel, the chestnut tree, the wishing well.
How about Daddy and Aslan?
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment. Each other's still means the world to me, just so you know. So So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. But it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first. That beautiful tale's too tucked in the bed all those nights. And I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she put a smile at me, I knew the love of father owns me. And I pray that she find you someday, but it's still hard to give her away.
It's only for a moment you were mine to hold. The plans that heaven has for you will all too soon unfold. So many different prayers I pray for all that you might do. But most of all, I want to know you're walking in the truth. And if I never told you, I want you to know that as I watch you grow, I pray that God would fill your heart with dreams, and that faith gives you the courage to dare to do, give you rooms and help you find your wings. Yeah.
greatest fear will be that you will crash and burn, and I won't feel your fire. I'll be the other hand that always holds a line, connecting in between your sweetheart and mine. I'm strung out on that line, and I'll be on the other end to hear it when it rings. I know the sky is calling, angel, let me help you with your wings. When you come back down, take care of
you. It was no accident. You're in my life. Smile down on me.
Tell me that something was missing in your eyes. In your eyes, baby, tell me that you live for love. That
okay, hey, we got a special request for all of the family members of Ray and Dorothy, was it? Ray and Mary Smith. Ray and Mary Smith, if you could follow the good-looking bald guy.
I think she'll cry, honey, so I'll wonder if you're smiling. You can hold her right.
Ray and Mary Smith. Okay, girls. This could only mean one thing, and especially one... Aslan, are you really going to put these on? Okay, come on and bring it. Oh, just a minute. Picture time first, and then Aslan and her bridesmaids are going to dance a little line dance. I don't even want to say it.
Double XL.
give it up for the Double XLers. Hey, they're not the only ones celebrating today. Somebody else is celebrating. Happy birthday, dear Paul. Happy birthday to you. All right. Happy birthday, Paul. Many, many more. No candles. Ran out of candles. Okay, that's a good idea. How about the little garter? Does anybody have a garter here? That was too short. I believe in miracles. Okay, bridesmaids and single ladies, let's line up right near the bridesmaids if we can. Single ladies, here we go by the bridesmaids. Any single ladies? Right where Aslan's pointing. Single ladies, gather on over. You could be the next lucky one to marry a stud like Brian. Okay, we got all the single ladies up. Single ladies are back there. Some don't look marrying age yet. Hold up, Aslan, we're gonna count to five. Ready? Ready, five, four, three, two, one. Okay, well, we'll wait 15 years, and then we'll start talking. But for 15, five, four, three, two, one. Oh, let's do that one over. Let's do that one over, Brian. All this marriage stuff is getting to your head, I think. Okay, here we go. Three, two, one. Who wants Brian to do it again? Because that was pretty weak. Yeah, one more time? Oh.